Today, we will discuss about the process of oogenesis. Clear? The total process of oogenesis. It is the process of formation of oogenesis is the process of formation of functional. Formation of functional haploid ova. Haploid ova from a diploid germinal cell of ovary. Clear? It is the process of formation of haploid ova or egg from the diploid germinal cell of ovary, means haploid egg is formed from the diploid germ cell of ovary. Clear? Diploid germ cell of ovary 2n and the haploid egg is n. This process starts when the female fetus is only 25th week old. Clear? This process starts, the female fetus is only 25 week old, means it starts before the birth. No oogonia is formed after the birth. Clear? The process of oogenesis is completed in three stages. These are number 1, multiplication phase. Second is the growth phase, and third is the maturation phase. Clear? First is the multiplication phase. In this phase, the germ cell of ovary, clear? The ovary is lined by germ cell, or it is called primordial germ cell. The germ cell of ovary undergoes differentiation. Clear? The germ cells of ovary undergoes differentiation and form the oogonia. Some millions of oogonia are formed in the fetal life. No oogonia form after the birth. This oogonia now surrounded by a number of cells. These oogonia are surrounded by a number of cells called the egg nest. Out of this number of cells of egg nest, only one cell develops into primary oocyte. And the rest cells are disintegrated. This sheath structure, is called primary follicle. Clear? A number of these follicles degenerate between birth and puberty. So, at puberty, only 60,000 to 80,000, 60,000 to 80,000 primary follicles are found in each ovary. So, around 60,000 to 80,000 primary follicles are found in each ovary. So, it is the process of formation of egg having three phases: multiplication phase, growth phase, and maturation phase. In the multiplication phase, the germ cells of ovary undergoes division to form a large number of oogonia. A large number of oogonia, which is diploid because this division is mitotic. Some 2 million of oogonia or gamete mother cells are formed in each fetal ovary. In each fetal ovary, some 2 million of oogonia are formed. The oogonia form egg nest, which is ensheathed by some cells and is called primary oocyte. Primary oocyte. Next, the germ cells of ovary divides by mitotically to produce a large number of oogonia. This division is mitotic, that is called mitotic differentiation, and such phase is called multiplication phase. Multiplication phase. All the cells are diploid. All the cells are diploid. Now, one oogonia of the egg nest grows in size and functions as primary oocyte. Clear? The one cells of the egg nest means the cell, functional cell, is surrounded by a number of cells. Clear? One cell functions as primary oocyte. The other cells of egg nest form an epithelial covering over it. It is called primary oocyte. And the other cells form the epithelium. And the structure is called primary follicle. Primary follicle. A number of these follicles degenerate between birth and puberty. At puberty, only 60,000 to 80,000 primary follicles are left in each ovary of fetus. Clear? About 60,000 to 80,000 primary oocytes are found, or primary follicles are found in each ovary of the fetus. Now, after birth, the primary oocyte undergoes meiotic I. The first division is unequal to produce a larger secondary oocyte, and a smaller first polar body. Clear? But the meiotic one is arrested at diakinesis of prophase one of meiosis one. The division is arrested at diakinesis of prophase one of meiosis one. When puberty occurs, the secondary oocyte is formed, or the further division of meiotic one starts, that is metaphase one, anaphase one, and telophase one, so that two cells are formed, that is secondary oocyte, which is larger, having bulk of the cytoplasm and yolk, and a smaller cytoplasmless first polar body. Now the secondary oocyte undergoes meiotic two. Again, this division is unequal to produce a larger cell called the ovum or egg, and a smaller cell called the second polar body. The meiotic two actually not completed, it is completed on the entry of the sperm. The meiotic two is arrested at metaphase two of meiosis two. The further division or development, that is anaphase two and telophase two, is completed after the entry of the sperm. Thus, from a single primary oocyte, only one ovum or egg is formed and polar bodies are formed. But in case of sperms, from a single primary spermatocyte, four sperms are formed.